be a shame. Avis Book, if I disappeared before the defenses were ready.
Of course, Superior.
Muttered the general. But without tremendous enthusiasm, I rather think. Everyone else must work, though, including your own soldiers. But you can't expect my men to... I expect every man to do his part. Anyone who doesn't like it can go back to Angela. We can go back and explain his reluctance to the Archlector. Doctor leered his toothless smile at the General. There's no one that can't be replaced, General. No one at all. There was a great deal of sweat on Bisbrook's pink face. Great drops of it. The stiff collar of his uniform was dark with moisture. Of course, every man must do his part. Work on the ditch will begin immediately. He made a weak attempt at a smile. I'll find every man, but I'll need money, Superior. If people work, they must be paid, even the natives. Then we will need materials. Everything has to be brought in by sea. Borrow what you need to get started. Work on credit. Promise everything and give nothing for now. If Eminence will provide, I want reports on your progress every morning. Every morning, yes. You have a great deal to do, General. I'd get started. Bisbrook paused for a moment, as though unsure whether to salute or not. In the end, he simply turned on his heel and stalked off. The peak of a professional soldier dictated to by a civilian? Or something more? Am I... to the Gurkish, perhaps? Vitari hopped down from the parapet onto the walkway.
His Eminence will provide? You'd be lucky.
Doctor frowned at her back as she sauntered away. Then he frowned towards the hills on the mainland. Then he frowned up at the Citadel. Dangers on every side. Trapped between the Archlector and the Gurkish, and with nobody but an unknown traitor for company. It'll be a wonder if I last a day. A committed optimist might have called the place a dive, but it scarcely deserves the name. A piss-smelling shack with some oddments of furniture, everything stained with ancient sweat and recent spillages. Kind of cesspit.